Okay, so I wasn't the last. You guys know this term?
The phrase? Netflix and chill? You're familiar with that?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, so here's the thing. Netflix and chill, it sounds innocent enough, you know. For instance, we enjoy the work of Max Riemelt and we relax. That's Netflix and chill.
Well,
it turns out that Netflix and chill actually means having sex. What you need to know is I do have a day job, okay? And I'm a high school teacher back in Henderson, Kentucky. And so they call me Mr. Goebel. And back towards spring break, Mr. Goebel didn't know what the double meaning for Netflix and chill was. And yet the students didn't.
Yeah.
When they come in the classroom, on the smart board, I'll have the iconic Netflix logo with the white background, the red letters, and they'll come into the class, and it'll just symbolize that they're gonna have an easy class that day, okay? So then a student comes in, and the first thing he says, and keep in mind, to me, Netflix and chill means just to relax. He sees the logo and he goes, "All right, Netflix and chill." In my mind, I thought, you know what? This young man has captured exactly what I'm going for the day before spring break. So I said, I turned to him and I said, "Yeah, man, Netflix and chill, I like that." This is where this story takes a turn for the worse. We teachers have hall duty. We have to supervise all the students. I went outside and I proceeded to tell at least 30 different students, "Netflix and chill in there, guys."
That was no sex education.
No. Sadly, it gets worse. I saw that it was getting a good reaction out of these teenagers when I repeatedly said Netflix and chill in my classroom. So like right now, I love laughter, it encouraged me. So I thought, why limit it to only my students? There's a young 15-year-old female, let's say Netflix and chill to her. Another young lady approaches me, "Mr. Goebel, I feel sick today. I don't think I can attend your class. Lauren, I think you'll do all right in there today. It's just gonna be Netflix and chill." I walk in the classroom after the bell rings, and a student finally took pity on me, Max. He said...
But he didn't call the cops.
No. He goes, "Mr. Goebel, you do realize for the last 5 minutes you've been talking about fucking." And I was like, whoa. No, I was talking about Netflix and chill. That's enjoying a streaming video service and relaxing, right, guys? And then 30 teenage heads in unison go.
Oh, no.
Yeah, so, and that's the story of how I lost my job. You see, what's going on here, the character emails a radio DJ that he despises. He happens to be a pop radio DJ who has become the bane of his existence. At work, he's always having to listen to this DJ yammer on and on and then play this horrible pop music. When I hear this, I've always fantasized about sending an email to this DJ and you know, just unloading on it. So this is what the character does. The DJ's name is Tug. "Dear Tug, I am taking this opportunity to let you know how much I dislike you. I am forced to listen to you and your god-awful music every day at work. I'm hoping that reading this email will cause you a few moments of discomfort because you've been causing me discomfort every morning for the last 2 years. I do not know which is worse, listening to you and your inane observations or listening to your station's mindless, soul-withering hit music. Honestly, the music you play is shit. Only assholes could possibly like your kind of music. As I listen to it, the same thought constantly pops in my head. How can anyone actually, sincerely like this? I also constantly wonder, do you and the other DJs actually like the music you play, or do you do so begrudgingly? It has occurred to me that maybe you hate your job as much as I hate mine. I'd like to think that you dislike the music you play as much as I do, but that you are having to play the role of a dutiful pop music DJ in order to feed children, which you likely conceived in a hot tub. I read you some kind of mean-spirited emails earlier, but to show you that I have matured and that I have a heart, this is the way that Dan from before ended things with that DJ Tug that he hated so much. So this was his, this was one of the last emails that Dan sent to Tug. Dear Tug, I'm sorry for all the hateful things I wrote. I'm what you would call a troubled person. God knows I don't want to be this way. I feel like my brain is at war with itself. I've been so mad at the world for so long because the world won't have me. That isn't your fault, though. I won't email you anymore. There is one last thing I want to say, though. A long time ago, I had this idea that I've never told anyone. When I got to thinking about my childhood, it reminded me of this idea of mine. It's a theory, actually. And the older I get, the more I realize that my theory might be true. My theory is this: there is no such thing as an adult. We are all just children. We grow taller, we gain weight, we get jobs. But all we ever really are is overgrown children. Adult is just a word that somebody a long time ago gave to really tall children. Adulthood, I would say, is the name of some unnameable illness. We use words like wisdom and experience, but we don't know anything. When I think of this idea, the world makes more sense to me because I realize that none of us know what we're doing. Even the greatest doctor is only doing guesswork. It's amazing we even make it through the day alive. We are all so helpless. So the next time you upset me on the radio, I will picture you and me on a playground, side by side, on the swing set, kicking our legs at the sky. We are not so bad that way.